U sred američkog srednjeg zapada, 4 sata vožnje od Chicaga u državi Iowa, smjestilo se selo Anamosa sa svojom slavnom kaznionicom. Ovo je ustanova s najstrožim sigurnosnim mjerama. Iza ovih kamenih zidova žive najnasilniji kriminalci. Mnogi od njih osuđeni su na doživotni zatvor i više nikad neće izaći na slobodu. Jutro su u teretani na dvorištu članovi banda, narkobosovi, seksualni predatori i ubojice.
I utilize it as a release to stress. Makes you forget about a lot of things sometimes, keeps you in a mode of clarity.
U ovoj kaznionici s najvišim stupnjem sigurnosti živi 1000 zatvorenika. Suživot im je katkad težak. Danas će iskra među zatvorenicima gotovo izazvati požar. 200 metara odavde izbila je opća tučnjava. U Anamosi se oglasio alarm za uzbunu. Sukobila su se dva klana od 20 zatvorenika. Čuvari moraju izbjeći pobunu. Treba im samo minuta da situaciju vrate pod kontrolu. Nema ranjenih, ali suzavac je ostavio posljedice. Jedan od šefova Anamose, Matt Evans, i članovi njegove uprave odlučili su se za izniman postupak. Blokirat će cijelu kaznionicu. Svi zatvorenici moraju natrag u ćeliju.
Could have started just an argument between two people, each in a different gang or different group. It's all speculation at this point. We have no idea. All right. Give me another one.
22 upletenih zatvorenika odlaze na najgore mjesto u kaznionici, u izolaciju. To je najstrožiji oblik zatvora. Spartanska ćelija bez i jedne osobne stvari. Tako žele navesti zatvorenike da progovore. Ali u zatvoru vlada zakon šutnje.
I'm saying, you don't say shit. You know what I'm saying? I can't be no snitch, you know what I'm saying? No rat in this way.
What happens after?
Your pride, your dignity, everything is drugged to the mud. You know what I'm saying? You're not a man no more.
Stražari će teško izvući priznanje. U ovom zatvoru šutnja je pitanje opstanka. Anamosa je kaznionica iz koje se nikad ne izlazi. Stanovnici je zovu dvorac. Neprobojni zidovi, dojmljiva arhitektura koja podsjeća na ukletu kuću. Ovaj zatvor sagrađen je 1880. i jedan je od najstarijih u Sjedinjenim državama. U proteklih 60 godina nijedan zatvorenik nije uspio pobjeći iz ovog čudovišta od kamena i čelika. Zatvorenici su pod stalnim nadzorom. Danju i noću na straži se izmjenjuje 200 čuvara.
With this being a maximum security prison, we have to be ready for the worst.
Prisluškuju se čak i telefonski razgovori zatvorenika. U Anamosi su glavni prioritet bande, zločinačke organizacije povezane s preprodajom droge, čiji su neki članovi iza rešetaka. Ovdje ti opasni kriminalci nemaju nikakva manevarskog prostora.
Harris, don't hang on the fence.
Na najmanju devijaciju u ponašanju zatvorenike šalju ove uske kaveze.
Life in America, gulag. This is America for you right here. That's it. Pin cages, they lock us up like animals.
U Ajovi se smrtna kazna ne provodi od 1965. Umjesto nje uveden je doživotni zatvor. U Anamosi 20% zatvorenika izdržava kaznu doživotnog zatvora. Oni više nikad neće vidjeti vanjski svijet. Kako bi izdržali, neki ubojice poput Si Loua mogu računati na svoje bližnje.
When you see your family for the first, a period of time, helps take your mind off of what's going on here.
Drugima je izlaz rad. Neki zatvorenici rade u zatvorskoj tvornici. Imaju povlastice da smiju izrađivati registarske pločice za malu naknadu.
About 140. I think underpaid and overworked, but making the best of a fucked up situation.
Mario je osuđen za oružanu pljačku. Uzoran je zatvorenik i ima pravo na ćeliju s 4 zvjezdice. Ali ovdje 4 zvjezdice znači samo 3 četvorna metra.
You see that? That's wall to wall. That's the ceiling. It's not big. If I go to move, I'm touching something.
Yeah. And I don't know.
Dobili smo iznimno dopuštenje da tijekom mjesec dana snimamo strogo čuvane zatvorenike u kaznionici Anamosa. U ovoj neprobojnoj tvrđavi treba poštovati strogi protokol pri dolasku na posao.
Come here, Matt. How you doing today? Oh, yeah.
What is that?
These are the stairwell keys that will take us up into the towers.
Postupak je ovako strog zato što stražar Jones radi u strateški najvažnijem kontrolnom tornju. Taj tornjić stoji sam u srcu zatvora. Gleda na dvorište na kojemu obična uvreda može izazvati nerede, kao tijekom tučnjave koju smo vidjeli.
Officer Dudley, how's it going?
Not a lot going on today. Yard's actually pretty light.
Okay.
Jones najprije provjerava svoju pušku.
This is my rifle and it's just to make sure that it doesn't have any rounds in it.
Stražari u nadzornim tornjevima poput Jonesa jedini su naoružani čuvari.
With this being a maximum security prison, we have to be ready for the worst. And that would be, of course, a riot where staff or the inmates are being harmed. And if we had to, then we would have to stop that, you know, but as a last resort. Also, too, the main purpose that it serves is a deterrent.
U 8 godina karijere Jones nikad nije zapucao. On ima ključnu ulogu, promatra ponašanje zatvorenika. Najpozornije motri bande. Kako bi predvidio njihove namjere, naoprezuje čim se zatvorenici počnu grupirati. Ne smiju se okupljati u skupinama većima od 6 ljudi.
Tower 4 to one of your officers, could you come down by the soap shop and break up that big group, please?
Jones je primijetio sumnjivo okupljanje. Devetorica zatvorenika na okupu. To je previše.
We don't want to get it over 6, and that's when you get a problem there. So we want to keep them separated, get some of them going. They see the officer coming. As they get closer, you may see some of them start to move before he even gets there. Just like we watch them, they watch us. They have time on their hands, you know, so it's just one of those things, and they try to stay ahead of us, we try to stay ahead of them, so.
Jutros će na dvorištu biti živahno. Kako bi zatvorenici mogli podnijeti svoje dugačke kazne, uprava zatvora dopušta im neke male slobode. Zatvorenici su se okupili u velikom broju kako bi prisustvovali najiščekivanijem događaju godine, velikom natjecanju u dizanju utega. Si Loua jedan je od najozbiljnijih kandidata za pobjedu, šef je bande, zovu se Bloods. Dok je vodio golem lanac preprodaje droge, Si Loua je ubio klijenta za kojeg je mislio da je doušnik. Izdržava doživotnu kaznu i već godinu dana trenira kako bi osvojio laskavi naslov najjačeg čovjeka u zatvoru.
I'm ready mentally. Gotta go in there. You gotta go in there strong. You can't let nothing interfere with your mentality. So you gotta just go in there and gotta kill it. I'm ready.
Ali Si Low će imati opakog protivnika. Napumpani Tony ulazi u arenu u pratnji svog tjelesnog čuvara.
Yep, you guys just stay with me, please.
Tony je veliki favorit natjecanja u dizanju utega. 3 godine zaredom pobjedio je na ovom natjecanju.
What? Yep, today's the day. Right now's the time. Yep.
Tony je zatvoren u anamosi zbog toga što je oteo maloljetnicu. S djevojčicom je bio u bijegu 6 dana. S njom je prešao cijelu državu, držao je zatočenu i uzastopno je silovao prije nego što su ga uhitili. Osuđen je na doživotnu kaznu.
All right, Mustard! 2018, let's do this with class. Let's be gentlemen. Let the best man lift, let your lift. Do your talking, guys. That's all you need to do. We're ready to begin.
Natjecanje se održava pod nadzorom stražara. Svi su došli vidjeti borbu divova, velikog favorita Tonija i njegova izazivača Si Lowa. Dvoboj počinje s visoko podignutom letnicom na 275 kg. Si Low je prvi. Si Low je sve impresionirao. Tony odgovara na izazov i stavlja utege koje za ovu priliku oboju u crveno. Njegov tjelesni čuvar na šipku stavlja maksimalnu težinu utega. Tony kani osvojiti pobjedu težinom kakvom se još nitko nije okušao u ovoj disciplini. Za njega je to veliki rizik.
This is for 755 pounds heavyweight.
342 kilograma, to je 67 kilograma više od Si Lowa. Šef bande Si Low je nokautiran. Tony mu je zadao težak udarac. Tony uživa u postignutom uspjehu. Potukao je rekord anamose.
Thank you, Charles. Yeah, I'm too sweaty to... He went good. Yep. It was just a lot of energy. That's why I only did that one lift, because it's so much weight and it's hard to almost do that again. It's ridiculous. I'm like super tired right now after that.
You're not afraid somebody's gonna beat that?
No, it's not. No, that won't happen.
And you're almost 50.
I know. Yeah, that's.
Hey, BD, did you hear us?
Tony misli da je nepobjediv. Ali Si Low nije spreman priznati poraz. Kako bi ostao u natjecanju, pokušava dići uteg od 297 kg. To je 45 kg manje od Tonija. Ne može podići šipku. Si Low se još nada da će postati novi najjači čovjek u zatvoru. Tony je dobro počeo i čini se kako će osvojiti taj naslov, ali u natjecanju će se dogoditi velik obrat. Ovi zatvorenici smiju sudjelovati u aktivnostima od 8 ujutro do 5 popodne zbog dobrog vladanja. Ali oni koji u anamosi ne poštuju pravila imaju malo drukčiji tretman. Treći kat zgrade D najomraženije je mjesto. Ovaj dio zatvora namijenjen je za izolaciju, to je zatvor u zatvoru. Ćelije su svedene na goli minimum. Zahod, jednostavan krevet i ni jedan osobni predmet. Ovi zatvorenici ovdje provode 23 sata na dan. Na jedini sat izlaska u danu idu pod pratnjom. Čak i kad izađu na zrak, ovi zatvorenici ostaju zatvorenim kavezima. Imaju samo 4 četvorna metra da protegnu noge. Čuvar Sathers već je 8 godina stražar u Onamosi i ovim najokorjelijim zločincima ne popušta ni milimetra.
They got to keep walking forward at all times. They can only walk, they can't run, they can't push-ups, they can't do set-ups or anything. They can only walk back and forth in the pens. They can't be yelling outside to other inmates. Other inmates can't be yelling inside here. If they don't follow the rules, they will get canceled and have to go upstairs. And then they lose exercise tomorrow.
Life in American Gulag. This is America for you right here. That's it. Pen cages, they lock us up like animals.
Sathersu nikad ne popušta pozornost. Čak i u ovim kavezima zatvorenici su spremni na sve.
They can't hang on the fences like this guy because it stretches out the fencing and it's metal and if they can break it off, make shanks out of it. So we don't want them touching the fence.
Sathers i njegovi kolege na najmanje odstupanja od propisanog ponašanja reagiraju posebnim metodama kao kod ovog zatvorenika.
I got a spit mask because when you threaten to spit on a staff or if you do spit on a CO or a staff member, you get put on this.
Neki od ovih zatvorenika mogu biti i mnogo opasniji.
Disrespected by the CO, so I stabbed the CO. So they moved me out of that prison to here. Prison life is, all you have is your front, your face in prison, and it's your life is at jeopardy if you don't stand on your on that on your word and on your preface of yourself. You know what I mean? And then if you don't do that, you end up being a victim.
Na svu sreću, izbodeni čuvar je preživio napad.
Scary? It makes you think a lot. Really does. How quick it can happen. Nothing's ever happened to me, but it doesn't mean it won't. So that's why you have to be aware of your surroundings and what's going on and how these guys are feeling, how they're talking, their stances, what their fists are doing. So just kind of be aware of everything around us. So.
Jedina šetnja u danu je završila. Ovo nisu sva ograničenja kojima su podvrgnuti. Idemo pod tuš. Zatvorenici u izolaciji imaju pravo na tuširanje samo 3 puta na tjedan i u kupaonici vladaju vrlo stroga pravila. Tuš je također ćelija. Čuvar Sathers zatvoreniku skida lisičine tek kad je unutra. Jedino čuvar Sathers ima pristup šamponu i sapunu zatvorenika. Još jedno ograničenje. Ovi zatvorenici nemaju pravo nositi vlastitu odjeću. Zato se Sathers iz opreza pretvara u dadilju.
Pair underwear, face towel, two socks, and we're rolling. Everything they need is right there in there. So we give them the clothes that we wash, the clothes that we know what's in them. Is why we do that. We don't know if they've stitched something in their clothing, or that's why we take it all away.
U međuvremenu se dogodio pravi kazališni obrat. Tony, zatvorenik koji je podigao 342 kg u natjecanju u dizanju utega, kažnjen je izolacijom. Optužen je da je varao, a otkucali su ga drugi zatvorenici. Ovaj čuvar zapljenio je ova dva crvena utega. Nisu čelični, nego drveni. Tony je ove savršene kopije izradio u drvodjeljskoj radionici, a da nije pobudio ni najmanju sumnju.
So this is one of the weight plates that they found with a fender right. It says 100 pounds on it, and you can see it's very, very light.
Let's go!
Prijevara je bila dobro organizirana već od početka natjecanja. Kako ne bi pobudili sumnju, Tony i njegov tjelesni čuvar brižljivo su zamaskirali ove drvene utege između dva čelična. Oni i njegovi pomoćnici trebali su jedini upotrebljavati ove crvene utege. Nitko drugi nije ih smio stavljati na šipku. U ovom strogo čuvanom zatvoru ne dolazi u obzir da takve spletke nekomu prođu nekažnjeno. Mogli bi uzrokovati napetosti između klanova.
A bigger concern would be if he was laying blame on somebody from a different race. Sometimes it doesn't take a lot to spark a big conflict in here. And something like that definitely would have the ability to do that. So it's something that we take seriously. Even something that's, you know, kind of funny, and those small things are the things that spark bigger confrontations here.
Čuvar je imao dobar predosjećaj. Tony ne samo da nječe da je izradio lažne utege, nego još tvrdi da je žrtva podmetanja.
It was just like I was purposely set up, so.
That's what you think?
Absolutely, to get out of there, because there was just too much done. They didn't even allow any different race judges. It was just the black ones, CeeLo's friends, and the other white guys that were supposed to be weight meet judges weren't even allowed in there. Probably because I'm the strong guy and they don't want to be no part of the weight meet. I feel like it was done to get me out of there, so that doesn't even make sense. I don't know. It's got me pretty sad. So.
Tony je vrlo drzak. Naime, sigurno je on organizirao prijevaru. Njegovi pomoćnici izbjegli su sankcije, ali on je okrivljen i provešće 15 dana u izolaciji. Još je gore što je taj kriminalac izgubio ugled. Tony je postao sprdnja cijelog zatvora. Ansi Lou slavi. Sad je on najveći snagator u Anamosi.
Everybody's amazed by that. So. I just never went against him. So now they're like amazed. They really know who's the strong one. So.
See you later. Yep. Good job, yep. Bro.
I'm shocked. I'm still shocked. It was genius.
Yeah.
Gotta give him that. You know what I'm saying? He tricked the shit out of me. I was like, I can't beat this.
Look,
he had me all fucked up. Shame.
Because he actually had a good reputation around here until that.
Yeah.
Now everybody gonna look at you like, oh, man, bro, you just, you had to do that to win.
That's all you have. You have a reputation, you have your word, and your name. Any of them three things get blemished, it's over for you. You're not who you say you are, so. Hey. I ain't never gonna forget
that's
that.
Going down to history,
yeah,
though.
That's history right there. That's super history.
CeeLo spada među 70% zatvorenika koji imaju slobodu kretanja u zatvoru. Već je 10 godina u Anamosi i živi u najvećoj zgradi. Ovdje je 380 zatvorenika raspoređeno na 5 katova. Sva Svaki sat ovi muškarci mogu ući u svoju ćeliju ili izaći iz nje zahvaljujući Samanti, jedno od rijetkih ovdašnjih čuvarica. Kako bi imala pod kontrolom ovu zatvorsku populaciju, aktivira neobičan mehanizam. To je nepromjenjiv ritual. Samanta otvara ćelije samo na minutu.
It's called a pin cage. So if I pop this up, that'll open their cell. And then these ones, that means that they don't want it open, so they're not here, they're probably at work, and they don't want their cell open when they're not here.
Ovaj sustav otvaranja s pomoću kabela nije se promijenio od izgradnje zgrade 1932. Silo je u ćeliji broj 37. Šef bande živi sam. Budući da je osuđen na doživotni zatvor, kupio si je opremu kako bi lakše izdržao.
So this is how we keep up on sports and whatnot like that. TV shows, anything, gotta have that. I got mine on the wall, kind of fancy, but that's how I did mine. And you gotta have a fan. It's like 93 degrees today, so if you don't have this, you're in torture right now. Torture. This is a must-have in prison. This fan. I don't care if you don't have a TV or nothing. Got this, you're all right. They have tablets. This is how you get your emails right here. So you have to have a tablet to have that. It's kind of like filtered. It's an internet, but it has a block. So you can have certain stuff like books, music, and it lets you get like poems and stuff like that. You know, I got my own space, and this is what keeps me really sane. This is the only place of peace you can have is here. So that's why I try to make it so comfy like that.
What is this?
This is my dream girl. That's Coco. That's she's a model. I'll never meet her. But she's somebody that, you know, I love her. Truly, that's my crush. Coco, that's my girl. You know, I love Coco. You don't have sex. And honestly, there's things, there's homosexuality, but I would never indulge in that. That's just never. But there's guys that do that. You know, sexually, hey, you just have to... Honestly, you gotta do what your man knows how to do. Masturbate. You know, that's what the pictures are for. That's the only thing you can do, you know? 10 years? Man, you don't have sex. And to be like that, your mind's gotta be strong.
Ovaj šef bande plaća kaznu zato što je ubio mušteriju. Do kraja života živjet će u ovoj ćeliji od 3 četvorna metra. Zauvijek je odvojen od svojih pobočnika, od kojih su već mnogi poginuli pod mecima.
These are my friends. Most have passed away, and some of them died in street life, bullets and guns. You know, happens to us. Since I've been here, I don't seen a lot of my friends die, so I keep them up to keep their memory alive. Me and them guys up there that you seen started an empire, so they're still. What we created out there now.
Silo se Bloodsima pridružio još kao tinejdžer i penjao se hijerarhijskom ljestvicom sve do čina generala Ajove. Premda je u zatvoru, nije izgubio smisao za biznis. Zarađuje novac za 30 članova Bloodsa koji su zatvoreni u ovoj kaznionici.
I hustle sometimes, like for instance, you know, you got stores in here, you know, somebody might be hungry. You want a bag of chips, here's one back, give me two back, you know. It can be 2 weeks, it can be 3 weeks, you know, I'll wait for it, you know. But that generates money so that my people can eat. Anything that they can't get their hands on, I get my hands on. Sell it, make profit, you know. That's how we make it in here, you know.
Can you sneak some stuff in
here? Well, you know.
You have your wings.
Yeah, you know. It could happen. You know, yeah, if I wanted to, yeah.
Pretjeruje li Silo kad kaže da ima takvu moć? Više od ovoga neće nam reći jer uprava nadzire sav promet robe. Kako bi nanjušila svako sumnjivo ponašanje, Ana Mosa računa na intuiciju svojih stražara. Zahvaljujući toj intuiciji, Jason Hewitt je prije 20 godina došao do velikog otkrića. Tada je bio još mlad čuvar. Cijeli zatvor poznaje ga kao čovjeka koji je spasio ugled zatvora. Jason je osujetio vrlo smion plan. 14. srpnja 1998. zaintrigiralo ga je ponašanje jednog zatvorenika. Zato mu je pretražio ćeliju. Pozornost mu je privukao malen razmak u podu, širok nekoliko milimetara. Kad je digao podnu oblogu, Jason nije mogao vjerovati svojim očima. Otkrio je tunel, dubok nekoliko metara.
They'd go under the bed and down. But if you look right around the edge of that hole, you can see the marks from the large drill bit that they were using to punch down through.
Jason je otkrio nevjerojatan pokušaj bijega iz zatvora. Dogodio se u zgradi pod najblažim nadzorom. Ovdje zatvorenici ulaze u svoju ćeliju s pomoću ključa i izlaze iz nje kad žele. Alatom koji su ukrali u radionici, desetak zatvorenika mjesecima se mijenjalo u kopanju tunela ispod zida zatvora kako bi pobjegli.
They had wired electrical cord throughout the tunnel, so they had lighting and electricity. They had fans in there to keep the air moving and keep them cool. What I thought when I opened that, honestly, the first thing I said was, oh shit. It's kind of a freaky feeling, so.
Tu iznenađenjima nije bio kraj. Kad se čuvar Hewitt uvukao u tunel, otkrio da izlazi u podzemni sustav ventilacije. Scenarij dostojan Hollywooda. Desetak zatvorenika moglo se kretati cijelom dužinom zgrade, ali najbolje od svega, izaći na zrak.
Up above, that's the sky. That's, you get up to the top and you'd be up on top of the roof of LUC. They had enough sheets in there, they could have made a rope and tied off one of those spires and climbed down the outside.
Čuvar Hewitt osujetio je najdomišljatiji i najspektakularniji pokušaj bijega u povijesti Ana Mose, nekoliko sati prije nego što bi se dogodio.
These guys have 24 hours a day, 7 days a week to think about things to do. You know, we're here for 8 hours a day trying to figure out what they're doing and how to combat it. So some of them are very ingenious.
Nakon ovog pokušaja kaznionica je betonirala pod u svim zgradama i začepila sve ventilacijske otvore. To je dodatni dokaz da iz Ana Mose nemoguće pobjeći. Što se tiče desetorice upletenih zatvorenika, svi su kažnjeni i razdvojeni po drugim kaznionicama u zemlji. U Ana Mosi su čuvari stalno u stanju pripravnosti. Ništa im ne smije promaknuti. Zato se za nadzor služe svim sredstvima. Ovo je jedno od strateški najvažnijih mjesta, telefonske govornice. Za $2 po pozivu zatvorenici smiju zvati u svako doba dana, a razgovor smije trajati do 20 minuta. CLO tako zadržava vezu s vanjskim svijetom. Ali u svojem kontrolnom tornju, stražar Jones sluša svaki njegov razgovor.
State Penitentiary in Anamosa, Iowa. To accept this call, press 5. You may enter a selection.
Cijeli dan snima i sluša razgovore zatvorenika. Stražar Jones uključio se u poziv i sluša ga, ali mi ga ne smijemo snimati.
Now I had to mute it because the calls are confidential. We can't let this go public, so that's why I put in the earphones.
Jonesu je glavni zadatak da osujeti planove banda. Zato pozorno sluša sve pozive vođa banda.
And you have some gang leaders
that are incarcerated. So they'll call and give orders. You know, could be witness tampering. You know, it could be somebody they're mad with. It could be try to arrange to have drugs brought in through a visit. And by monitoring this phone, you know, it's a very important tool. We're able to keep a grip on stuff like that.
Nedavno je čuvar uspio izbjeći najgore. Presreo je poziv jednog člana bande koji je naručio ubojstvo svoje cure koja mu je bila nevjerna.
There was a guy here. He's a jealous boyfriend. He had called somebody that he was part of a gang with, and he told them that he wanted his girl hurt, and he wanted the guy that she was riding around with hurt. And the guy asked him, said, "Are you sure?" He said, "Because I'm going to the gun show." So by me being able to catch that, we was able to deal with that, to stop any more communication on the phone. He ended up doing segregation time. Yeah, it can save lives.
U Anamosi je prisluškivanje javna tajna. Kad razgovara sa svojim bližnjima, Silou je još uvijek svjestan toga da ga slušaju i ima svoje metode da prevari sustav.
I can't say anything about Bloods because they'll say it's a game. So if I'm talking to somebody that I used to associate with on the streets, they can talk the way they want to talk, but I'll have to decode the way I talk. Right? Because at any given time, they can take your phone call and lock you up for what they want to lock you up for.
Ovdje je 30% zatvorenika povezano s nekom bandom. Čak i unutar ovih zidova imaju jak osjećaj pripadnosti. Odanost je način života, kao kod ovog pljačkaša koji je član Cripsa.
People call it a game and they see all the negativity of it, but it's a family. I would kill for mine and I would die for mine also. That's just what it is. And when I got into it because my mom got me into it. And so, like, and it's not something easy to get away from. And if I had a choice, which I do, to get away from it, I wouldn't want to, because I've done too much for them. They've done too much for me.
U ovom zatvoru prerezati vezu sa svojom bandom znači izložiti se smrtnoj opasnosti. U Anamosi postoji zaštićen odjel koji se nalazi u krilu zatvora s najjačim osiguranjem.
Yeah, seven's over aces.
Ace is over jacks.
Kako bi izbjegli odmazdu, ovi bivši članovi banda odvojeni su od opće populacije i ovdje žive 24 sata na dan. Ova dvojica zatvorenika protjerani su iz Peckerwoodsa, bande ekstremno nasilne krajnje desnice.
I ended up marrying a Puerto Rican and I got a Hispanic kid, so they got mad at me for that.
In 2010, those people that were like the shot caller, the guy that was running it, I didn't agree with his politics. And other people got wind of it, so they took me off the yard. They beat me up while I was eating. So then since then, they just, they don't want me back on the yard. They don't want me on no yard, so you get stuck here.
Yeah.
Kod ovih bivših članova banda navike je teško iskorijeniti. Iako je zabranjeno, kartaju se i kockaju za novac.
You can go to the hole, you can get locked up for gambling.
You can play cards without gambling.
Yeah, as long as you're not gambling, but...
But there's no point in playing if you ain't playing for money. So I'm not going to play for free, it's a waste of time. I'd rather make some money off it.
And here, what happens if you don't pay the other guys?
We fight. We go to the cell and we fight.
We're coming in your house.
And if you don't want to go to the cell, we'll do it out here. And then when I get locked up, my homeboy's still going to collect on you if you don't want to pay. You're going to pay the debt. One way or another, you're paying. $3.
Kako bi došao do svojeg novca, ovaj zatvorenik bio je spreman na najgore dok je bio na slobodi. Zbog toga je i završio u ovoj kaznionici.
I had to stab some dude because he wouldn't pay me my money. And they, I almost got a life sentence, but I got to pled down, so I'm good now.
It was super high doing it.
Yeah, I was all twacked out on meth, and I ended up stabbing dude in the neck and the forehead because he wouldn't pay me. I had to
every other body part you stabbed him in the forehead.
Why? The head, dog. I'm trying to kill you. You ain't going to pay me. I'm trying to get you.
Kako bi se ovakvi obračuni izbjegli, u Anamosi ne cirkulira nikakav novac. Svaki zatvorenik ima debitnu karticu koju može napuniti u kaznioničkoj banci.
Barbs, how you doing? Get five on there.
$5.
To je elektronički novac. Svi zatvorenici imaju interni zatvorski bankovni račun. Puni ga obitelj ili novac stječu radom unutar ovih zidova.
When they need money on their debit card, I am the one that can put money on their card. Money comes in, it's dispersed onto their account, and then they can have money placed on their debit tech from their account. So yeah, just a better way to regulate it all together versus free range of cash.
Na ovom prozorčiću pred čuvaricom Vargas prodefilira mnogo zatvorenika. Jer u ovoj banci je i kaznionička trgovina. Zatvorenici ovamo ne mogu ući, ali debitnom karticom kupuju svakojake namirnice kako bi poboljšali kvalitetu svakodnevnog života. Sladoled za $2.50, čips, hamburgere za $1, ali i svježe voće.
We don't have good meals in the chow hall that night. We usually, so then you see a giant line out there.
Ali čuvaricu Vargas ne mogu prevariti. Kad zatvorenici kupuju puno proizvoda, znači da pokušavaju stvoriti lanac preprodaje. Zatvorenicima ova trgovina zapravo služi kako bi platili kockarske dugove.
I just kind of keep my eyes open. As far as guys coming over, purchasing those big orders, that's a big indicator that maybe there's some gambling going on or maybe there's a debt being paid, that kind of thing. So I look for that. You're just always watching what goes out the window.
Yeah.
Rad omogućuje zatvorenicima da izbjegnu trampu i da legalno zarade novac. U Anamosi ima 8 tvornica. Izvršavaju narudžbe koje im daju javne tvrtke. Radionice upošljavaju zatvorenike kao jeftinu radnu snagu. U ovoj kaznionici radi 67% zatvorenika. Jedan od njih je Mario. Sad je 6:45 ujutro. Kao bilo koji drugi radnik odlazi na posao svaki dan u tjednu.
I gotta go to work. That's license plates. I work in license plates. Printing plates all day.
Mario i još 20 zatvorenika izrađuju sve registarske pločice koje se izdaju u državi Iowa. To je oko milijun na godinu. Proizvodnja kontinuirano traje još od 1926. Ali u ovim tvornicama imaju pravo raditi samo uzorni zatvorenici poput Marija, zato što rukuju opasnim alatima.
Probably the only place I can actually keep this in my pocket would be here. Because I have a lot of things that I need to cut throughout the day. So it's a lot easier if I got the box cutter. I've probably got about 10 years report free. You know, it's kind of easy to stay out of trouble if you want to. And it kind of goes with the job, though.
Mario je osuđen za oružanu pljačku, ali u ovoj radionici radi već 10 godina. Ovdje je radio sve. Počeo je tako što je pospremao, a danas tiska pločice.
It's coming up right now.
Zahtjevi su isti kao u vanjskim tvrtkama.
What I'll do is, there's a slight yellow tint. On top of that, I'm gonna try to get rid of it.
Very picky.
Yeah, well, again, if you do a play, you wanna do it right. You know what I mean? So, might as well do it right or don't do it.
U državi Iowa kvalificirani radnik zarađuje $12 na sat. Bez obzira na stručnost, Mario je daleko od takve plaće.
much do I get paid? About 140. An hour. I think underpaid and overworked.
Dolari 40 centa je 20% minimalne plaće u državi Iowa. To je vrlo isplativa radna snaga, a Mario je među bolje plaćenima.
If you compare it to a lot of the other jobs in the prison, I make way more. I make double what the average person makes. So if the average person is making 70 cents, 75 cents, I make almost double that. So the bigger picture to it is it's not so much the amount of money they pay us, it's the cheap labor that they have by housing people here and keeping them here so long. The amount of time that they give people is, you know, it doesn't fit crime and punishment, as they say. It doesn't fit. When you go into other states, people don't get 25 years for armed robbery. They get like anywhere between 6 to 10. Here. Yeah. Yeah, 25 years for that.
25 godina za oružanu pljačku supermarketa u kojoj nije ispaljen ni metak i nije bilo ozlijeđenih. Otkako je zatvoren, Mariju su umrli roditelji. Može računati samo na sebe.
Right now, this pays the bills. And that's the way I look at it. This pays the bills. You know what I mean? If you get here and there's no one sending you money, you're going to need a way to survive. And right now, this is my means of survival right here. It's all up here. It's what you do, what you make of it. And that's what I'm doing. I'm making the best of a fucked up situation.
U 14:45, Mario je završio svoj osmosatni radni dan.
You want to see what I make? Let me show you. That's the number of hours I got paid. 55 hours, 37 minutes, $76. 20 cents. That's what I got so far. It looks like I missed 2 minutes one day.
And so you're held accountable for those 2 minutes?
Yeah, somebody took it off. Yeah, that's it. No, don't hate, y'all. I'm not the biggest. There's other people who make money like me.
Prije odlaska Mario mora vratiti skalpel.
Here you go, Mike. That's
it. Radnici smiju izaći tek kada vrate sav alat.
That's it. My job is done here.
Čuvar u radionici radi inventar alata. Sve je to potencijalno oružje.
What could happen? Who knows? Take it back to their house, try to break out, stab somebody, anything, basically. So it's always, you know, I gotta make sure all this stuff is here. This is always locked. Everything's always locked up.
Da Mario nije vratio skalpel, poslali bi ga u izolaciju i nekoliko tjedana ne bi smio dolaziti na posao. Mario živi u zgradi namijenjenoj za služenje dugotrajne kazne. Izaći će tek za 7 godina. Kako bi izdržao, svaki put kad se vrati s posla ima svoj mali gušt.
It's one of the best parts about my gallery. You can see the streets. You hear me? You see it? You can see the streets. There's not maybe a lot of sea to see, but you can still see the people are living their lives out there. It's not on the inside. That's why I chose this gallery. This is pretty good for a view. At the other side, you see the inside of the prison. I see that every day. You get to see people and they're still out there living life. It's something you kind of look forward to. Some people can stand it, some people can't. I like to know that there's still life out there. It ain't all just COs and lockup. You know what I mean? I mean, you can smell the air. That's free air coming through that window. This is locked up air. That's free air right there. I mean, as soon as you cross those bars, it's a difference.
Marija više gotovo nitko ne posjećuje. Ali drugi imaju više sreće i još imaju obitelj. Dvorana za posjete je mjesto na kojem ovi zatvorenici osuđeni na duge kazne pronalaze snagu za život. Dva puta mjeseci Lou provodi po 3 sata sa svojom partnericom. To je poseban trenutak. Ima vremena i za svoju 21-godišnju kćer Sijanu. U dvorani za posjete pravila su vrlo stroga. Silo ima samo nekoliko sekunda da zagrli obitelj, inače gubi pravo na posjet. Svaki fizički kontakt promatra ovaj čuvar. Jer nedopuštene stvari obično ulaze kroz dvoranu za posjete, a spolni odnosi su zabranjeni.
You got different looks.
I gotta change it up sometimes. It's really long. I like dreads. It makes him look young.
Oh, that's what it is?
Yeah.
Tata joj je uhićen prije 10 godina. Sijana je tada imala tek 11 godina.
I just thought like he just got in trouble, he'll be back. Nothing serious. But it turned out to be something serious. They hid it from me for a long time. Because we're really close. I was always with him every day. So it's kind of weird.
When did you realize?
I think my 13th birthday. When he said he always told me he's gonna come home, but you're like, you know, he missed another birthday, so you know, I got over it.
Were you mad at him?
No, I couldn't be mad. No, like, cause we're too close for me to be mad at him, so I was like, you know. Got sad, but still got mad.
Don't call them. Even though I'm in here, yeah, I try to stay tight with her too. You know, it's hard because I'm distant, but the phone calls and the visits help keep that.
Sijana i njezina majka teško prihvaćaju činjenicu da je Silo osuđen na doživotni zatvor.
I don't like to think about him. Life's a life. I'm glad he's still alive and still breathing. I still come see him.
I know you would make
it's a blessing and a curse.
Yes, it is.
Obiteljski život zauvijek će im se svoditi na ove trenutke u dvorani za posjete.
We say too. Okay? Let me speed. Oh well.
You better take that to Greg. You'll never be me again like that. You better take that.
Okay. Call me later.
I will. Yeah. Bye. Bye. Now, when you step in here, that's when reality hits you. Saying from there to here, you sit down and you be like, okay, now reality is. I utilize the pictures to keep me going. You know what I mean? Daily life. I keep that in mind and
every daily choice that I do in here, I think of her and what effect did it have on her if she's not able to see me because I made a mistake or I did something stupid to risk what we have right now. So she's really the one who keeps me grounded. My daughter keeps me grounded a lot.
Čak ni najjačem čovjeku Anamosi nije lako prihvatiti konačnost svoje sudbine koju dijeli s još 50.000 zatvorenika u SAD-u osuđenih na doživotni zatvor. Mario pak ima svjetliju budućnost. Osuđen je zbog oružane pljačke i trebao bi izaći 2025. ako se i dalje bude dobro vladao. Tada će imati 54 godine.
Well, y'all gonna keep going?
Mario se nada da će živ izaći iz ovog zatvora, ali i drugi zatvorenici ovdje će ostati do posljednjega daha. Pokojnici koji nemaju obitelji, čije tijelo nije nitko tražio, počivaju u ovoj zemlji, na kaznioničkom groblju. U ovoj urni je pepeo zatvorenika koji je umro u dobi od 65 godina i bio je osuđen za silovanje.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me.
I oni koji umiru u najvećoj samoći u Anamosi imaju pravo na isti obred kao drugi. Do kraja ih prate članovi uprave i zatvorski čuvari. Došli su otpjevati posljednju molitvu kako bi obilježili odlazak jednoga od njih. Kao i uvijek, umirovljeni čuvar Rick pripremio je posljednje počivalište ovog zatvorenika.
Everybody should have a decent burial. And even though they are an inmate, they're still a human.
Otkako se kaznionica u Anamosi otvorila, u ovoj zemlji život su završila 152 zatvorenika.